Hello friends, in this video we are about to see on how to enable TDS on purchases which is effective from 1st July 2021 using MaxERP software. So to do this you have to go to the file menu and go to book settings, search for 194. So you'll find an option called enable TDS in purchase vouchers. Just enable this menu and click save. Second step you have to do is you have to go to masters, go to taxation, go for TCS and TDS master. In this, if you do not have any details entered, you can enter a new row with details as mentioned on your screen as 1 July 2021 for vendors with PAN numbers or Aadhaar card, the percentage will be 0.010, and for vendors without Aadhaar or PAN it will be 0.1. This percentage are same as TCS too, so if you already have TCS details entered here on this screen, then you need not do any changes. After this you can directly go for a purchase. Here we'll see a couple of examples. So once you go to purchase, here you can just mention the vendor's invoice number, whether it's a cash purchase or a credit purchase. Let's say we take a value of 3 lakh. So we have a couple of vendors. So this particular vendor's turnover for the current year has already crossed 50 lakhs. So TDS is exempted to the limit of 50 lakhs. After 50 lakhs, different amount will have the TDS applicable. So for this vendor, since the turnover 50 lakhs is already crossed in the current financial year, it is asking us an option on the screen whether to enable TDS for this vendor. So you can just give yes. And let's say we are just making a value of 3 lakh worth of bill. You can see a TDS 194Q option on the right hand side in the summary section, which is editable. By default, it will get auto calculated. So you have, as per 0.01%, it is calculating to rupees 30 for TDS. Now, once you save this, the TDS also gets posted in its ledger. We'll see another example of another vendor. Let's say we are having a 30 lakh. So for this vendor, the current year turnover is around 25 lakhs as of now. And let's say we just enter another purchase for, once we cross the limit of 50 lakhs, so basically 25 lakhs earning, which is the current year turnover, and another 30 lakhs in this bill, it is automatically enabling the TDS tool on this vendor. And once you click OK, so it is calculating just 500 here. Since the vendor's PAN number is not entered, it is calculating 0.1%, and this 0.1% is calculated only on the balance 5 lakh. For example, for this vendor Shiva Distributors, we have 25 lakhs as a current turnover already available in the current financial year, and 30 lakhs of this bill. So total turnover is 55 lakhs. Up to 50 lakhs is exempted, and for balance 5 lakhs, 0.1% is being calculated as TDS, and that which is rupees 500, and you can save this. Then you can go and verify the TDS ledgers. If you want to see the details, you can just go to ledger report, go for TDS account, and you will be able to see all the transactions where TDS have been affected. So two purchase bills, we have 30 in one and 500 in one. In case if any vendor has been enabled with TDS mistakenly, or if you want to alter the TDS application on particular vendors, then you can go to masters, vendors, search for the respective vendor. And you can go to edit. Under the settings tab, you'll have an option for apply TDS in purchase. So here you can manually disable or enable the TDS for this vendor, as well as you can even update the TAN number here, and you can save it. That's all with this video. Thanks a lot for watching. Great day.